You're looking at the members from Armored Saint. We want to welcome you to our wacky and crazy world here in the bridges of Pasadena, where we love to hang and trip.
The video you just saw was called Lesson Well Learned, and that was one of our first gigs. It was at a roller rink called Billy Barty's. He was actually there, and it was pretty crazy.
Oh my God! Can you see my brain?
March of the Saint.
Yeah, remember Prickett's Palace? Two knights, good and evil, fighting it out.
The awesome intro. Check out the winner, too.
Oh! that camera for? You know, you better get to work. If you don't get to work right now, I'll fire you.
Right now, you're going to take a look at the one and only video, production video that Armored Saint has made to this day. It's for a song called Can You Deliver from the March of the Saint album. And we had a lot of fun making this video. Shot it in 2 days, shows a little bit of the band's acting ability and some of the band's real ability, and that's on stage. Check it out, Can You Deliver?
Yeah!
that sounds pretty familiar.
Yeah.
The next couple videos you're about to see are videos I've collected from the road. They were shot by fans, bootlegs, if you may, and they're really cool. Check them out. You'll dig them. Hey, check it out. One of our favorite Dice quotes. Hickory dickory dock. This bitch was... Hey, what? Are we out? Yeah. Hickory dickory dock, the bitch...
We'll be right back.
know you guys. What's happening? Just a little bit of a memory refresher here. To the right here is Mr. Phil Sandoval with his nicely trimmed goatee, jamming on his Ovation round back there. He's a original member of Armored Saint, played on the March of the Saint album, did a lot of writing for the Delirious Nomad album as well. To his left, this guy with the tattoos, only guy with a tattoo in this band, said he gets more of them, will probably become big and famous. There's Jeff Duncan, who played in a local band called Odin, who played a lot of shows with Armored Saint back in the early days, and also has done a lot of writing for this upcoming record that we're about ready to put out here in a couple of months. Let's talk a little bit about the late Dave Prichard, guys. What are some of your fonder memories, Phil, of Dave Prichard?
Well, the first time I met David Prichard was at a local music store, Petrini Music, and he had a songbook of Van Halen's first album. And right off the bat, I knew I was going to be in a band with this guy, and he was an intensely creative individual, you know, beyond anything else. And I'll always remember him. I think about him every day.
How about you, Jeff? What are some of your more fond memories of Dave Prichard?
Well, Dave, like Phil said, Dave was a real creative guitar player. That guy could write a monster riff if anybody could. I remember he's the king of the one-liner. One time we were sitting backstage after a gig, and we were all sweaty with towels on, just kicking back, and this girl came in, and she was drinking this drink called Fuzzy Navel. And she went up to Dave, and she said, "Here, you want some? You ever had a fuzzy navel?" And Dave lifted up his towel, and he goes, "You ever had a fuzzy testicle?"
Alien.
This is the record company where we bullshit, you see. This is where we're kissing ass and saying, "Oh yeah, how much we like them," when they're not doing anything for us.
My guitar stand, yeah, rock and roll.
Next two videos you're gonna see are from the Raising Fear tour. We did a live broadcast for Minneapolis, First Avenue.
It's one of the greatest rock capitals of the world, and you will see by the look on the fans' faces why that is so.
Enjoy it.
This one is about a vampire. He goes by the name of the Human Vulture.
Wow!
this one for ya. Ooh,
I lost my pencil. Somebody got my Pepsi mixed up with my Coke.
One of the things that Dave always wanted to do was to tour Europe. And in May of 89, his wish came true. We got to go to the Dynamo Festival in Eindhoven, Holland, to play in front of 22,000 screaming maniacs.
This next clip is one of my personal favorite songs called Stricken by Fate. And here it is, Eindhoven, Dynamo Festival, Complete Madness. This is the last show that we played with Dave. It was New Year's Eve, 1989-1990. It's definitely one of the more memorable shows that we've played.
Yeah, Dave always loved to play live, as we all did, but this one particular show was the last one, and little did we know that, you know, it would be the last one. After that, things happened that were just out of our control and, you know, pretty devastating as far as that goes.
The song that we're going to show is Book of Blood, which has a cool intro and probably one of Dave's all-time favorite songs. He does a great solo in the middle. And we're glad that we got this last show on tape because it means a lot to us. Enjoy it.
Yeah.
Well, we hope you enjoyed our trip through Red Times. Lots of Armored Saints still to come for the future. Dave would be real happy that we got Jeff, we got Phil back in the band, and he wants us to continue on, because that's what we're doing. And he was the craziest guy in the world that he would actually sacrifice his own home for a party, but it had to be on St. Patrick's Day, being that he was the Irish red-headed maniac. So this is a shot from it. It's called Long Before I Die, from Dave's parents' living room. Sorry, Mr. and Mrs. Prichard, but you didn't know about this one.
We'll be coming at you real soon, so check it out.
Yeah.
See ya.